Good morning, friends. We are starting with the module 5 under that first chapter, Instrumental Methods of Analysis. And in this session, we will be discussing about the introduction and potentiometric estimation of FEAS. What is this instrumental methods of analysis? Chemistry deals with the generally, when we talk about the analytical chemistry, it deals with the chemical analysis. The chemical analysis is carried out by two methods. They are quantitative method and qualitative method. Okay, first let us take a qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis is identification of an element from a compound or a compound from a mixture, etc. Like this, you should have done in a second PO. Salt will be given to you. Like this, we will be doing many confirmatory tests. And finally, we will be identifying the element which is present in the given salt. That is qualitative analysis. Just we are identifying. Second one is a quantitative analysis. Quantitative analysis is like you are finding about the quantity, amount of the substance present. Like by titrimetry, gravimetric methods, titrimetry or volumetry it's called as you'll be finding out the amount of the substance present, total hardness, percentage of calcium oxide. Like that, you will be finding out the amount of the substance present in the given solution. Okay, yeah, you know, like in these methods, what may happen is whatever the results we are obtaining may not be 100% accurate. Okay, but still, this good old methods are only in use. But the thing is, we may not get 100% accurate results. So, the instrumental methods of analysis came into existence. What is this instrumental methods of analysis? Whatever the chemical signal that is taking place, it will be converted into the electrical signal and which can be measured by using suitable devices. Like in potentiometry, we will be measuring the potential during the redox titration. That is measured by the device of potentiometer. The chemical signal is converted into electrical signal. That is shown on the, you know, particular instruments, potentiometer, conductance, we are measuring in conductometer, like that. And by using these values, we are plotting the graphs and all the values will be taken graphically. So, the results what we are getting here is 100% accurate. Okay, here it will not be causing error. Okay, error will not be caused here. Whatever the results we are getting is 100% accurate because we are taking all the results graphically. The examples for the instrumental methods of analysis are potentiometric estimation, conductance, and colorimetric estimation, etc. Clear? Let us take the first experiment, potentiometric estimation. The aim of the experiment is we have to find out the amount of the FEAS present in the given solution. FEAS solution will be given to us. We have to find out what is the amount of FEAS present in the given solution per liter. Potentiometry is used to determine the concentration of the substance in the solution and also to determine the pH of the solution. Okay, you know, here these potentiometric titrations are of two types. Okay, acid-based titration, we are using in a determination of pKa, and coming to the redox titration, we are using in a determination of potentials. Okay, two types of potentiometric titrations are there. Here usually we will be taking the redox titration as an example. Principle. What is the principle of potentiometric titrations? We will be measuring the potential when the titration is in progress. Okay, when the titration is going on, the analyte solution will be there in the beaker and you will be adding the standard solution from the burette. Okay, reaction will be going on in a beaker. Okay, we will be bubbling the solutions to mix so that it will be showing the correct potential. Then after each addition, we will be measuring the potential. So the principle here is we will be measuring the potentials when the titration is in progress. Okay, here in potentiometry, what happens is the potential will be increasing slowly, and at a equivalence point, there will be a sudden jump in the potential. Okay, this sudden jump is used to plot the graph, and from there we have to calculate the amount of FEAS present in the given solution. Instrumentation. Potentiometric instrumentation, it consists of a digital potentiometric will be there, potentiometer will be there, and indicator electrode platinum, and a reference electrode like a calomel electrode or silver chloride electrodes are used here. And then, you know, during the which is done when the titration is in progress. So, very simple apparatus, potentiometer will be there, electrode used here are the indicator electrode, that is platinum electrode, and the reference electrode is either calomel or silver chloride electrodes are used, and the potential is measured when the titration is in progress. Okay, See here how the potential is calculated in the instrument. The relationship between the electrode potential and metal ion is given by the Nernst equation. E is equal to E naught plus 0.0591 by N into log of Mn plus. Okay. You know, it's clear from the above equation that the potential depends on the concentration of the metal ions. Applications of potentiometry are redox titration. Example is potentiometric estimation of FeS. And for acid-based titrations, example is a determination of pKa of the given weak acids. Okay, so let us take the first application, potentiometric estimation of FeS by using standard potassium dichromate. Here, requirements are in burette, we are taking potassium dichromate, and in beaker, we are taking a, FeS solution. Okay, that will be given. And we are adding to that dilute H2SO4 will be added one test tube, that is to provide the acidic medium, and electrodes used are platinum and calomel electrode assembly. Accessories are a potentiometer. Okay, the procedure here is in this titration, FeS will be taken in the beaker and one test tube of H2SO4 will be added to this to provide the acidic medium and also to prevent the air oxidation of the FeS. And you know the electrode assembly, platinum and calomel, no, they are immersed in the solution and are connected to the potentiometer to measure the potential. You know, potassium dichromate will be added from the burette in the increments of 0.5 ml and the potential is measured after each addition. Okay, after each addition of the solution, it will be bubbled well to mix the reagents. Okay, and then the potential is measured. Initially, potential increases and nearby the equivalence point, there will be a sudden jump in the potential. Okay, why is it happen? Let us see. What happens here is when the reaction is going on, what will happen? When you add small amount of potassium dichromate, the small amount of FeS is oxidized to ferric sulfate. Okay, what's the reaction here? Ferrous sulfate is oxidized to ferric sulfate and potassium dichromate is reduced to ferrous sulfate. Okay, so if initially we will be measuring the potential for Fe3 plus and Fe2 plus systems. Okay, we are measuring the potential for ferrous and ferric ions. Okay, it will be given by Nernst equation form like this. Log of Fe3 plus by Fe2 plus we are measuring. Okay, Fe3 plus form will be increasing because all the FeS is oxidized to ferric sulfate when we keep on adding the potassium dichromate from the burette. At last, what will happen? All the Fe2 plus ceases to exist. Why? Because all the FeS is completely oxidized to ferric sulfate. And at the same time, what will happen? There will be introduction of Cr6 plus and Cr3 plus ions. The presence of slight excess of potassium dichromate brings a existence of Cr3 plus and Cr3 plus ions. That's why at the near the equivalence point, there will be a sudden jump in the potential. Getting no? Initially, we are measuring the potential for ferrous and ferric ions. Near the equivalence point, what happens? No more ferrous ions are there. All are oxidized to ferric. The excess addition of the potassium dichromate will introduce a Cr3 plus and Cr6 plus system. We are measuring the potential for it. So, there will be a sudden jump in the potential. And the equivalence point is determined by plotting a graph of delta E by delta V against the volume of potassium dichromate. Okay, we should plot the graph first. That is by taking any x-axis, volume of the potassium dichromate added against y-axis, delta E by delta V values. Okay, so when we plot the graph, when we take delta E by delta V against volume of potassium dichromate added, you will be getting a peak like this. And at the center, you should draw a line and you should mark it as equivalence point. This equivalence point is used to calculate the amount of FeS present. Okay, so this is the volume of potassium dichromate required. What does the equivalence point give here? Volume of potassium dichromate required will be given by this. Okay, there is a simple calculation like this here. Okay, normality into volume of FeS is equal to normality into volume of potassium dichromate. So we want the normality of FeS here. Okay, how to calculate it? That is by just N into V calculation. N into V FeS is equal to N into V potassium dichromate. See here, normality of potassium dichromate will be given to you. Volume of the potassium dichromate you will be getting from the graph. Volume of FeS is already given. Okay, 25 ml. So when you calculate, you will be getting the normality N. Once when you get the normality N, you have to multiply the normality by its equivalent weight. Once when the normality is multiplied by its equivalent weight, okay, you will be getting the amount of the FeS present in the given solution per liter. Very clear now, guys. Very simple. You have to take in beaker FeS solution. You have to add one test tube of H2SO4 to that. And you have to dip calomel electrode and a platinum electrode assembly in that. That should be connected to the potentiometer. And you are carrying out the titration. How are you carrying out? You will be adding the potassium dichromate from the burette in the increments of 0.5 ml. And after each addition, you are bubbling the solution. Okay, and you are noting down the potential. There will be a slow increase in the potential in the beginning. And near the equivalence point, there will be a sudden jump in the potential by plotting a graph of delta E by delta V against the volume of potassium dichromate taken, you will be getting a peak, and at the center you will be drawing the line, that is the volume of potassium dichromate required for the experiment. Okay, and by doing the calculation you can find out the amount of FeS present in the given solution per liter. Okay, so with this potentiometric estimation of FeS is over, dear friends, and we will be meeting shortly with a new topic. Until then, take care. Bye bye.